Hello students, in our previous video we have seen various examples of the point groups and also about the matrix representation and the various concepts of the group theory, right? Now we will see the another important thing, the most important thing in the group theory, that is character table. And if you watch our these 2 to 3 videos, then you will secure your 4 marks in the CSIR NET exam definitely, because a 4-mark question from the character table must come every year in the NET exam, right? So firstly you have to clear your doubts about the character table. What is the character table? Firstly you have to understand it, how we can read the character table. So in this video, firstly we will understand about the character table and how we can read it, how it is prepared, okay? And in the next videos we will solve the various questions, all the questions that has been come in the CSIR NET exam, with explaining all the concepts behind them, right? So firstly understand what is a character. In our previous video we have seen the matrix representation of the point groups. Now we see the character table. Firstly see the character. Character is what? Suppose this is the matrix representation of the identity operation, right? So in this matrix, if we sum up these diagonal elements, these numbers that are on the diagonal 1, 1 and 1, if we sum up them, then we will get the character for this identity element. It means this character is represented by this, this is called the chi. So the character for the identity will be equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1. It means it will be equal to 3. Similarly, the character for the C2 element will be equal to minus 1 plus minus 1 plus 1. It means the character for the C2 element will be equal to minus 1 plus minus 1 plus 1. It means it will be equal to minus 1. Okay, so we have to just add the diagonal numbers so that we will get the character for that particular element. Okay, now the another important term is here, the representation. What is representation? We have said that in the point group there are different symmetry elements, and for each symmetry element there is a matrix. So the complete set of the matrix for a particular point group will make a representation. It means if we collect all the characters, then it will make a representation, right? Representation may be of two types. One is called the reducible representation and another is called the irreducible representation. What is reducible representation? When a representation can be reduced further, it means it can be divided into smaller representations, then it is called a reducible representation. And irreducible representation means when a representation cannot be further divided, it cannot be further reduced, it is the smallest one, then such type of representation is called the irreducible representation. Okay, now we comes to our most important term, that is the character table. What is a character table? A character table is the collection of all the characters of an irreducible representation of a particular point group. When we collect all the characters of an irreducible representations of a particular point group, then it makes a character table. For example, we have taken here the character table for the C2B point group. It means we have taken a character table for the H2O molecules. Now you don't need to remember this whole character table. You don't need to mug up it. Why? Because it is never asked about this. We does not have to make this character table in the exam. This is given to us. Sometimes it may be happen that one representation is blank and we have to put here the values for this. Or sometimes these symbols are not given and we have to put them. So I will tell you how we can find out them. Okay, so you does not need to remember this whole table. So we will here study how we can understand this whole character table, how this is read up. Okay, so in this character table you can see here, then there are 4 columns, first column, second column, third column and the fourth column. okay, and on this corner, this is the corner, and firstly in this corner we will write down the point group. It means the shown flies symbol for the point group we will write here. For example, for H2O molecule the symbol is C2V, right? So we have to put here the C2V, okay. Then in the second column we have to put down the symmetry operations that we done. We know that in the case of C2V point group there are four symmetry elements: E, C2 axis, sigma V xz plane and sigma V yz plane. So we will write down them, okay. Now afterwards what happens, this is the column, and first these all are the representations, these are the irreducible representations. There are 1, 2, 3 and 4 irreducible representations, and these are the whole, these 1 and minus 1, these are the characters of these irreducible representation. In general the irreducible representations are given by this symbol, this is called the gamma, right? So this is called the Bethe notation for the irreducible representation. So in general if we don't know these symbols, then we will write down like this: gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3 and gamma 4. In this way we have to write down, okay. These are the Bethe notations for the irreducible representations. These all are the irreducible representations. And what is this A1, A2, B1, B2? These are the Mulliken symbols. This is the Bethe notations. And these are the Mulliken symbols. We will understand about it in afterwards, okay. Firstly, we write down what is these things. Then we will study about them in detail, okay. These are Mulliken symbols and these are the characters for these different symmetry operations. We have seen that each symmetry, when we carry out any symmetry operation, what happens? Suppose we have given an H2O molecule and we carry out an operation C2 axis on it, what will happen? It will put the molecule in the same position. We get the identical molecule after the operation. But if we concern about any part of the molecule, then what will happen? It will affect somewhat to that part of the molecule, okay. So we will see here this thing. This one denotes that the function is symmetric, okay, and minus one shows that the basic function is anti-symmetric, okay. Now we comes to the third and the fourth. These are the functions, transformation functions. It means these x, y and z, these are the actions. The transformatory function of these x, y, z axis and these rz, ry, rx, these all are the, this will be rx, these are the rotation about the axes, and these are the square of the Cartesian coordinates in the fourth column. And these two columns are used if we have to find out the IR or Raman active modes, okay. Okay, so firstly we see the Mulliken symbols. What are the Mulliken symbols? These Mulliken symbols are actually A, B, E and T. These four symbols are called the Mulliken symbols, and these symbols are used to identify these irreducible representation. If we write down these gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3 and gamma 4, then how we will identify them? So for their identification we use such symbols. These are called Mulliken symbols. For example, for the one dimensional, for one dimension we use A and B. These are used for one dimension. This E is used for two dimensional, and this 3 is used for three dimensional representation. It means when there is only one representation of any type, then we use A or B. If there are two representations, then we use E, and if there are three representations, then we use T term, okay. And how we can identify them here? If this identity operation has a value of 1, in all these cases for this H2O point group, these are 1, 1, 1 and 1. So all are A and B. If any E value is 2, then we will use E. Suppose if there is 2, then we have to use here E. And if there is 3, then we have to use T, right? So these are used for 1, 2 and 3 dimensional properties, okay? Now, how we have to identify between A and B? How we can identify between them? For this, we have to see the principal axis. It means this C2 axis, that is the principal axis. If its value is symmetric, it means if its value is 1, then we will use the A notation. In both these cases, this is 1. So this is used A1 and A2. Okay. And if it is anti-symmetric, it means if its value is minus 1, then we use B term. Right. Then the third thing we do, we have to put down these subscripts 1, 2. How we will put down them? For this, we have to see the vertical plane. If this vertical plane is symmetric, it means if its value is 1, then we will use the subscript 1. And if it is anti-symmetric, it means if its value is minus 1, then we will use the term 2. Okay. Now there is another subscripts, that is G and U. Then how we will use them? These are used when there is any symmetry element inversion present. This inversion operation is not present in this case, but it is present in another point groups. There may be inversion symmetry element present, that we denote by I. If it is present and if its value is plus 1, it means if it is symmetric, then we will use G term. It means when it has value of plus 1, then we will use G. And if its value is anti-symmetric or minus 1, then we will use the subscript U. Okay. Then another term there is a superscript, that is dash or double dash. Then how we will use them? These are used when there is a horizontal plane present. It means if there is a sigma H plane present in any point group, and if its value, its character is plus 1, it is symmetric, then we will use the superscript dash. It means if it is A, then we have to put a superscript like this. Okay. And if its value is minus 1, then we will use double dash. It means like this. Right. So these are the Mulliken symbols. Okay. Now the another question is that how we can find out these characters, these written as 1 or minus 1, how we can find out these? Actually, for this, we have to see this third column. In the third column, we have given the different functions, z, x, y, etc. These are the axes. We know that when we carry out the symmetry operation, what happens? Suppose we carry out the C2 axis, rotation about the C2 axis, then what will happen? Whole molecule will change to the another transformation, and we get the same product after the operation that we carry out. But suppose we see only the transformation of only one orbital or only a part of the molecule, then how it will transform? Suppose we see when the z-axis, transformation of the z-axis. We know z-axis is the principal axis for the C2V point group, and along the z-axis there is pz orbital. So we have to see the transformation of the pz orbital. It means when we carry out the different symmetry operations, how this pz orbital will transform. Suppose these are the three coordinates and this is the pz orbital, right? Now when we carry out on it the symmetry operation E, we are carrying out the symmetry operation E, then what will happen? We have to rotate it by 360 degree along the z-axis. So there is any change in the orbital? No, there will be no change in an orbital. This plus orbital will remain here and this minus will remain here. It means there is no change. So when there is no change, then we use the plus 1 sign. Okay. Another thing is C2 operation. When we carry out the C2 operation, what will happen? In situ operation, we rotate about the axis, along the z axis. We have to rotate the molecule by the 180 degree. Then what will happen? As this orbital is lying along the z axis, then there is no change in this orbital. It means this orbital will remain as it is. So this will also be plus one sign, right? Now see the third operation, that is the sigma v plane. And this plane is the vertical plane. There are two planes. One is the xz plane and another is the yz plane. And both are vertical. So there will be, if we put a plane in this way, then there is no change in this orbital. And if we put the plane in this way, then there is no change in this orbital. It will remain as it is. So both the vertical planes will also be plus one and plus one. It means when we see the transformation of z axis, all the characters are plus one. It means we are getting a completely symmetrical representation, that we say A1. It means the first line plus one, plus one, plus one, plus one. So we are getting the A1 reducible representation, right? Okay, now see the transformation of the x axis. It means the transformation of the px orbital, as the px orbital lies along the x axis. So what will be the result when we carry out any symmetry operation in the C2V point group? Okay, firstly see, when we carry out the identity operation, we know that it remains all the operations as it is. In the identity, the molecule remains as it is. When we rotate by 360 degree, what will happen? This orbital will rotate in this way and it will come to its same position. So there will be no net change. So its value will be plus one. We get the character plus one, right? Now when we carry out the C2 operation, it means when we are rotating it in the way of this along the z axis by the angle of 180 degree, we are rotating. Okay, then what will happen? This lobe, this plus one, this plus side will come here and this lobe will come here. It means there is a change in its symmetry. So we are getting a sign of minus one. Now when we carry out the sigma xz plane, then what will happen? There will be no change in the orbital. Why? Because this plane is along the x and the z axis in this way. Okay, so its sign will be plus one. And when we put a plane sigma yz, it means when a plane is in the y and z directions, then what will happen? This will change the lobes of this orbital. It means this lobe will come here and this will come here. So we are getting a sign of minus one. Now look at these characters. The value of C2 axis is minus one. It means its value will be B. We are getting an irreducible representation that will have a sign B. So this will it is representing this B1 representation. 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1 for the transformation of the x-axis. So we are getting an irreducible representation B1. Okay, now we see the transformation of the y-axis. It means the transformation of the py orbital, because the py orbital is lying along the y-axis. So when we carry out different operations, what will happen? Firstly, carry out identity operation. So we know in this case, it will remain unchanged. So the value will be plus one. Okay, now another operation is C2 axis. It means rotation about Z axis by 180 degree. Then what will happen? This lobe will come here and this will come here. So we are getting a negative sign. It means this orbital is changing its sign. So we are getting minus one. Now carry out another thing, that is sigma xz plane. Okay, now what will happen? This plane is along the x and the z directions. So this orbital, that is along the y axis, will change its sign. This will come here and this will here. So we are getting a sign of minus one. And when we carry out the operation sigma yz, it means when we are putting a plane in the yz direction, then what will happen? As we know, this orbital is along the y axis, so there will be no change in the sign of this orbital. This orbital will remain as it is. So we are getting a sine of plus 1. Okay, now you can see here the c2x has a negative sign, negative character. So this operation, this representation will also be b, and here we are getting a b2 representation. Plus 1, minus 1, minus 1 and 1 for the transformation of y-axis. Okay, now see the transformatory properties of the dxy orbital. How the dxy orbital will change its sign. Okay, these are the two axes, x and y axes. And where is the z axis? The z axis will be in this way. Okay, now when we carry out the identity operation, we know it will leave the orbital as it is. So its sign will be plus 1. Now carry out the another operation C2. It means when we are rotating along this z axis, that is in this way, by an angle of 180 degree, then what will happen? This will rotate like this. It means this orbital will come here and this will come here. So there is no change in the sign. The sign will remain as it is. So we are getting a plus 1 sign. Now see the planes. Firstly see sigma xz plane. When we are putting a plane in the x and the z directions, then there will be a change in the sign. Alright, so it will have a negative sign. And similarly for sigma yz, when we are putting a plane in the yz direction, then there will also be a change, because these lobes will come here and this lobes will come in this direction. We are getting an opposite orbital, so it will also be negative. So we are getting plus 1, plus 1, minus 1 and minus 1. Now see the C2 axis, it is plus 1. So we are getting a type of the irreducible representation. It means A2, 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. We are getting A2 for the transformation of the xy orbital. So this is our video about the character table, how we can read a character table and how we can find out the answer of different questions. Now in the another video, in the next video, we will see the GOT theorem, the great orthogonality theorem, and we will also solve the questions that has been come in the CSIR NET exam related to this. Okay, thank you.